This is the service of worship for the First Baptist Church of St. Paul for August 18th, 2024. A couple of announcements. We will have our regular English Tuesday morning Bible study beginning at 10 o'clock. The trustees will meet on Tuesdays at 5:30. The Junior Church Leaders Retreat will be Wednesday, August 21st through the 23rd, and Karen Youth Choir will meet at 6 o'clock on Friday. An upcoming event to which all are invited is the council meeting, Saturday, August 24. The biennial meeting, the gathering of the churches of Iowa and Minnesota, will be October 4th and 5th. We are making an announcement of that in this week's bulletin. If you're interested, you can contact the office for more information. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
God of light and love, your light calls us forth to follow and serve you. Your light calls us to goodness, right living, and truth. Help us to wake up to the light of your love so your light may shine on us, making us children of the light, as we let your light shine for all the world to see in our service, in our words, and in our actions.
Fail.
responsive reading. In the past, you were full of darkness, but now you are full of light.
We will live like children who belong to the light.
Light brings every kind of goodness, right living, and truth.
We will try to learn what pleases the Lord.
The light makes all things easy to see.
We will wake up and let Christ shine on us.
Amen. Precious gift of your Spirit in our lives. We thank you that you are our guide, that you are trustworthy, and in all things we can believe and have faith. We praise you, Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, for the ways that you have shown us by your life, by your words, your teaching. This is how we are to live. We praise you, Holy Spirit, for your filling of us, for a love that does not die, your ever-present presence with us. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. We have come to worship today. Open our minds and our hearts to the inspiration of your Spirit. Forgive us, Lord, when we have forgotten that you are the light, that you are the center of our lives. Forgive us when we have pushed you to some corner instead of relying on you. Lord, it is hard to trust sometimes in the face of so many difficulties and trials and problems. But we pray that we would be open to your love, because this is what you intend for us. May we not be shy about being dependent upon you for all things. We pray a prayer of confession now, silently before you, recognizing that this is how we get right with you again. and right with ourselves. Hear our silent prayers of confession. From the cross, Lord, you offered us forgiveness. Forgive them, for they do not know what they do. How often this represents us so well. Thank you. Thank you for this gift of starting over, beginning again, being nourished by your love. We pray for ongoing strength and protection for Rosalind Yeo, for Puzar Tu, for La Gay, for Jonathan, Pina Tru, Maggie Porter, Oscar White, Terry Capel, T. Ushui, Lame. We pray, Lord, especially for the Denning family and for the family of Benjamin Ong at his recent passing, the family of Doc Lay at his recent passing. We pray for Dave and Jerry Johnson's daughter, Cara. We pray for our church in this time of transition. And we pray for the church around the world, and especially those people in Burma, our brothers and sisters, under the oppression of a government that mistreats and creates an environment in which it is so difficult to carry on. We pray for the people of Haiti and in Africa. We pray for the war that's going on in Palestine and Israel. We pray for the people of Ukraine. Lord, help us and help our leaders to find a way forward that does not rely on violence, but that trusts in a peace that is more than just the absence of violence, but a shalom, a gift from you. Help us, Lord, to find our way to shalom. Lord, we pray for our leaders, especially in this election cycle, when so many small things get elevated to some kind of national problem, when in fact there are so many things that we could do if we would recognize our common humanity and our common cause. Lord, we pray that you would be with our leaders, that we could find common purpose, and that we could serve all the people. May our public servants remember that they are public servants, servants of the people. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for this day. Thank you for your presence, for your community here, for the ways that you will lead and guide when we are open and when we are pliable vessels to your hand. We pray all this in the name of Jesus, who taught his disciples to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Hear our prayer, O Lord. Hear our prayer, O Lord. Incline thine ear to us and grant us thy peace. Walking in sunlight, all of my journey, over the mountains, through the deep vale, Jesus has said, I'll never forsake thee, promise divine that never can fail, heavenly sunlight, heavenly
scripture today is from the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verses 8 through 14. In the past, you were full of darkness, but now you are full of light in the Lord. So live like children who belong to the light. Light brings every kind of goodness, right living, and truth. Try to learn what pleases the Lord. Have nothing to do with the things that are done in darkness, which are not worth anything, but show that they are wrong. It is shameful even to talk about what these people do in secret. But the light makes all things easy to see, and everything that is made easy to see can become light. This is why it is said, "Wake up, sleeper, rise from death, and Christ will shine on you." Amen. I think it's fair to say that Minnesotans really know how to enjoy summer. We like to get out and enjoy it as much as we can. Camping, fishing, riding bikes, walking around the lake, going to the cabin, having barbecues and parties out in the backyard, soccer tournaments, family reunions. Sometimes it's amazing that there's anyone here on a summer Sunday morning. Our winters are so cold and long that summer comes and Minnesotans just want to get out and soak up as much of that summer sunshine as we can. But you know, I don't think it's just the warmth that we look forward to. I think it's also the light. During those winter months, the days are so short that it feels like we wake up in the dark, maybe go to work or school in the dark, and then we come home again in the dark. But the summer is full of glorious light. Even on a rainy summer like this one has been, the skies may be cloudy, but the days are still long. We wake up in the light, we go to work in the light, and we come home and it's still light. And there's just something about waking up in the light that makes it easier to be grateful, to open your eyes in the morning and sincerely thank God for a new day. The first verse of our scripture makes me think of that Minnesota summer light. In the past, you were full of darkness, but now you are full of light in the Lord. When we decide to follow Jesus, our lives can feel like the change from a long, dark winter to a beautiful summer's day. It's amazing what a difference it can make. We feel that light and love enter our lives, and it's like the darkness just lifts away, and we feel so grateful for that light. But this scripture reminds us that as wonderful as it is to bask in the light of God's love, to be in God's presence and soak up all of that goodness and light and love, that isn't enough. This isn't all that we're supposed to do. We're supposed to live like children who belong to the light. Last year for Mother's Day, we invited people from the church to send pictures of themselves with their mothers or their children. And there were young mothers with children and babies and older mothers with adult children. And there were even a few pictures with multiple generations, mothers and grandmothers and children and grandchildren all together. And when you looked at these pictures, you could often see a family resemblance. a mother and daughter who have the same eyes, or a mother and son who share the same smile. And looking at those pictures, you could tell who they belong to, whose child they are. And that's what we are asked to do. Live like children who belong to the light. Live our lives so that people look at us and say, "Oh, you must be a child of God." Because as Christians, we are called to live differently than non-Christians. We are called to live in a way that shows that we are children of the light, followers of Jesus, who is the light of the world and who called us the light too. And I'm sure you've met people like this, people who just seem to have an inner light that comes out in their kindness and caring, their compassion and their generosity. They seem to just radiate love and goodness, and people are drawn to them. And sometimes we look at those people and we think, "I could never be like that. I'm just not that good." And I hate to tell you, but it's true. None of us are that good. Even those people who seem lit up with kindness, they can't do it on their own. The scripture doesn't say that we are just full of light, but that we are full of light in the Lord. It isn't our light that shines, it's God's light that shines through us. It's God's love that shines through us. We can't do it on our own, but only through the love of God. Because there's a wonderful thing that happens as we start to follow Jesus, as we daily feel God's love for us, as we study the example of Jesus, who love just radiated to everyone around him. And as this happens, we begin to find ourselves wanting to share that light, to let the love and forgiveness and compassion that we are given daily start to come out in the love and forgiveness and compassion that we show to others. And when that happens, that is when we begin to become a light. As the scripture says, light brings every kind of goodness, right living, and truth. But it also says, try to learn what pleases the Lord. Letting our light shine is a choice that we make every day. And that choice is made up of many little choices throughout the day. Every day we have to make choices. What is the good thing to do? What is the right thing to do? And sometimes those choices will be easy. It will be obvious what is the right thing to do, and it'll be easy to do it. But sometimes the answers aren't easy. Sometimes it's hard to tell what is good or what is right. Or sometimes we know what's right, but doing it is hard. And we will do the wrong thing sometimes. We will make mistakes. But the important thing is to keep trying. Keep trying to choose the good. Keep trying to do what is right, Keep trying to live like a child who belongs to the light. Keep trying to learn what pleases God. But you know, even when we fail, when our light fails to shine, when we do the wrong thing, God's love keeps shining in the darkness. And one of the beautiful things that this scripture tells us is that the light makes all things easy to see. And everything that is easy to see can become light. Before, when we were living in darkness, sometimes we couldn't even see the wrong we did. But once we find ourselves in God's light, we can begin to see the wrongs that we have done. And you know, sometimes that can be really painful. It's hard to see the mistakes we've made or to see the darkness in our heart. But it's only when we see these things that we can begin to change. God's light might show us things that we don't want to see, but once we've seen our darkness, seen our mistakes, our sins, only then can we be transformed in the love of God's light and forgiveness. And you know, maybe I'm being too simplistic, but I truly believe that it all comes down to love. There's an old camp song called "They Will Know We Are Christians by Our Love." And you know, I truly believe that title just says it all. When we act in love, when we make choices based in love, when we treat each other with love and kindness and respect, then we are letting God's light shine through us. And just like a beautiful, sunlight-filled summer's day, when we let God's love shine through us, it fills us with joy and gratitude. It can make us want to sing. I can hear the words from Praise Song: "Shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King." We don't let the light shine for our glory. It's for God's glory. And when that light shines, it doesn't just shine on our life. It shines on lives all around us. That joy and gratitude is contagious. When you share your light and goodness with someone, it lightens up their day. And then they are likely to go and let that light shine on someone else. And before you know it, the whole world just seems like a brighter place. Sometimes on a beautiful summer day, it can be tempting to wake up and just let yourself soak up the morning light. And some days we just want to soak up the light of God's love. But God's light and love isn't something to keep to ourselves. It's meant to be shared. And I don't know, there must just be something about this scripture that makes me want to sing. But all week as I've been studying this scripture, I've been thinking about another camp song. And it goes something like this: "So rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. You are a child of God, a child of the light. So live like it. Wake up, rise and shine. Let the light of Christ shine on you. And then let that light shine on everyone you meet. Amen. Now, go in peace. Go out to let the love of Christ shine through you. Amen.